And welcome once again, ladies and gentlemen, to Overwatch Apex Season 2. I am Doa, with me is Monte Cristo, and today, the global teams return. That's right, we've got Envious and Misfits playing today in our two matches. First off, BK Stars trying to get their first win of the season against Envious, and then Africa Freaks Red takes on Misfits. Should be a good set of matches.
Absolutely. Exciting stuff, especially that second one, because it is do or die for both Africa Red and Misfits, more or less. Meanwhile, BK Stars looking to get that big win. They did lose 0-3 to Meta Athena, looking potentially like one of the weaker teams in this tournament. But that said, Envy squeaked by, just winning Escort and Hybrid maps against MVP Infinity, and they didn't look like their old selves.
Well, they looked rusty. You know, I mean,
very rusty.
It's a team that looked like they had just gotten off of a plane a couple days before, that they hadn't really been practicing a ton recently, which, of course, all those things seem to have been true. So now that they've been here for a while, the jet lag is gone, the practice has happened, I'd assume we're going to see a lot better Envious today than we did before. Going over to the BK Stars side of things, I would say kind of a disappointing start for those guys. Wow, I love this sign. Tank meta equals pray for Chip. No way, man. He gets like nano boost all day every day. He gets unlimited healing.
The Coco face is my favorite. It's a great sign. Good stuff.
That's awesome, yeah. So, but that's the BK Stars, right? Burner and Bunny, such a great combo last season. Not quite able to match up to Hoon and Saya player, of course, that they played last week. They also brought in Twilight, who's a good Ana player, but the team as a whole didn't really seem to have a lot of cohesion. So there's a lot of things I think that BK Star needed to work on if they're going to have any chance of beating Envious today.
I think when we look at BK Stars, and we've talked about this a little before, yes, in the first season when Overwatch, the meta wasn't as refined as it is now, and they were very good at executing a Graviton Surge and Pulse Bomb combo, they were impressive. But
sure,
I do feel that other teams, in terms of coordination and communication and strategy, have really outstripped them as we make the transition into this new season. We'll have to see, of course, how they perform. They have been playing a lot of Genji and Tracer at Winston, which does work well on this patch. And Envy, this will be their first game on the current patch.
Yep.
And we have questions about them as well. Can they play Genji is a great one, right? Taimu has to fill that role, I think, a little bit more now.
Yeah.
We've seen them play a little bit of Tracer, but when we look at a lot of the strong dive comps, these are not heroes that have been played by Envy in the recent past few months.
Yeah, and again, I mean, it's all going to have to come down to what they've been able to accomplish in these last couple weeks of practice. It's going to be interesting to see where they're at. But my big question, the pressing question for me today anyway, are we finally going to get to see a global team win a control map? We have not seen that all season. Maybe today, who knows? Here's how our groups are looking right now. Of course, going to take a look at groups A and B today. Envious with a chance to tie up Meta Athena in terms of match wins anyway, with a win here. BK Stars would really love to get a win as well, because if they lose today, this group is kind of decided.
Yeah. They're out. It'll just be whether Envy or Meta Athena in that final match will, in fact, take first place or second place within the group.
Right. So, a lot could be locked up today already in Group A. But then again, if you look at that group, you have two arguably very good teams and two teams that are, you know, maybe not quite as much, although MVP Infinity, I've got a little bit of hope for those guys in the future here. As we've said already, our matchups today, our second one, Africa Freaks Red versus Misfits, that should be a really good one too. I'm excited about that because Africa Freaks Red were very close to winning a lot of those games against Lunatic High. Sure, it was a 3-0, but it was about as close as it could have been.
Well, worth noting too that it was before the Lunatic High roster mix-up, before the latest patch, which I do think really favors Lunatic High.
Yeah,
sure. We'll have to see exactly how Africa Red is going to perform on that, but they do play, even in the last patch, a lot of, again, Genji and Tracer, these dives compositions that have proven to be powerful from teams that are very good at executing them. And Misfits was sort of all over the place strategically in their first best of five. So they really were hoping to see a more refined strategy from them. Sign for Mickey.
Mickey! Mickey's a great guy. A great guy, but pretty much only D.Va player. So we'll see if he's adapted a little bit. We saw more Zarya from him last week, so you'd imagine that we're probably going to see more sort of flexibility from him in that tank role this time around, too.
Yeah, it depends on what they want to play. Obviously, D.Va is weaker, but still perfectly playable.
It's viable,
in the current,
sure.
Perfectly viable in the current meta. And if they're going to be going with the same style of triple tank plus soldier compositions that we've seen, of course, comboing Reinhardt, D.Va, Roadhog, soldier, sort of the bread and butter that we've seen from Envious, it's still perfectly workable. And the thing is that even if it may not be the most ideal composition to run on this patch. Their execution is excellent.
Yeah, that's right. And, I mean, Taimu, you mentioned, can he play the Genji? I'm looking forward to seeing him on the Roadhog. And, so it's going to be, this is like a,
we were trolled.
Like a special thing, yeah, that's right. It seemed like we were going to go with the video, but it was a little bit too early. Yeah. Instead, it's just a promotional thing that you guys don't get to see because you're not Korean. Well, you might be Korean, but you're not watching the Korean broadcast. That's the important thing. If you want to see the promotion, you got to be in Korea.
But if you want to see us, which is superior, then
way better.
Then the promotional stuff, you get to watch this one instead. But, yeah, I agree. It comes down to how diverse is Envy's basically hero pool is going to be right now. Can they play some more of these projectile heroes that they haven't shown as much proficiency with since the departure of Tailspin?
Well, I mean, you want to talk about like pick diversity. I mean, we should definitely talk about Afrika Freaks Red in our second match. Those guys played the exact same comp on attack, on defense, pretty much all match long with like no variation at all.
It's definitely the highest percentage. We'll get to that in a little bit, though.
We'll have plenty of time to talk about it. But flexibility, we could say that could be one of the keys of the day. We need to have like a little graphic that pops up, like Monty and Doe's keys of the day.
Certainly. Showing these new heroes is going to be very important. But yeah, I think Envy probably going to be pretty comfortable going up against BK Stars in at least this first match.
Should be. I mean, you'd imagine it'd be one side. Let's find out more about these guys.
The most difficult thing against MVP is maybe they know how Envious play, so it's hard for Envious. Most difficult.
Envious가 루키가 이렇게 힘든 점이 많지 않았었는데요. 이렇게 어렵네요. 많이 넘어가겠습니다.
저 Envious는 뭐 피지컬적으로 팀원 중에 떨어지는 선수가 없어서 제일 큰 강점인 것 같고.
The last season, people always play like three tanker or four tanker, so we have to prepare for Tracer and Genji too, and it's quite hard for us.
특히 그 중에 타이무 선수가 맥크니만 잘한 줄 알았는데 로드호까지 되게 잘해서 걱정입니다.
I heard that they have a very good Tracer, like they call a bunny. So maybe we're gonna run something for counter Tracer and like make him change hero so we can play easier.
엠비어스의 강점인 3탱을 파괴시킬 수 있는 전략을 찾아서 연습을 해야 될 것 같아요. 얘들아, 많이 떨지 말고 이번에 엠비어스 경기에서 꼭 이길 수 있었으면 좋겠다.
For BK Star, I have some word to say to you. Prepare for get break by Team Envious. 장난이야.
All right, well, I'm prepared to see people get wrecked by Envious. I don't know if BK Stars quite is. We'll see. I mean, these guys certainly are capable of putting up a fight. Burner and Bunny are a legit good combo, even if they didn't look it in their first match. And yeah, I mean, a good point to bring up too is Carpe improved. They've got a little bit of stage experience now. Maybe some of the nerves are gone.
Perhaps, but when we hear Envy talk about basically counterpicks to Tracer and Genji, the thing about Taimu is that we've seen how good he is at taking out, especially ulting Genjis by using the Roadhog hook. He's very patient. He knows when those ultimates are going to be available, and he can shut them down extremely well. So that's the scary thing, is that Envy is strong in this meta without necessarily playing those heroes just because they're so used to countering them themselves. So I think it's going to be really, really tough to deal with the Roadhog. I assume that's what we're mostly going to see from Taimu, although you never know. The McCree, if there's a Tracer, might be coming in. In fact, Envy has played more McCree than most other teams so far in this tournament.
I mean, Harry Hook has played plenty of good McCree games over the course of his career, so if they need it, they've certainly got someone who can handle it.
Yeah, and when they haven't been playing Triple Tank, They were playing a lot of D.Va Reinhardt with Soldier and McCree running a pretty standard, but I would say more old style, old meta 2-2-2 composition.
Wow, Internet Hulk's hair is so blonde now. We're going to call him like Internet Malfoy now or something like that.
The gray hair.
Yeah.
It's great.
Love it. Like super blonde hair, not really gray hair. Even Lucius Malfoy had like pretty light blonde hair. There you go. Well, that's enough about Lucius Malfoy's hair. Let's talk about Team Envious. You like that segue? I think that was pretty good.
You nailed it.
Coco looks too happy today. I'm a little bit worried that he's going into a too cocky of an attitude.
Yeah, especially because the fans had the signs for hashtag Coco face. You can't be smiling. He's even smiling too much in this picture.
See, that's kind of a smirk. That's about as much as I'll accept from Coco. I think if we leave it at that level, I won't be worried about overcome. There we go. That's much more like it. There we go. Coco, game face on. They are ready to go. Chips high and an inspirational Anna for us all, of course. And this team, I mean, it was a 3-2 victory over MVP Infinity. I think Infinity brought a lot of stuff they were not necessarily expecting, and including being much better than they thought. But now, practiced, rested, this should be the Envious of old.
Yeah, absolutely. And they'll have a much better time now, because part of the problem that a lot of the Western teams faced when they came into Apex is that the Koreans never really stopped playing heavy dive compositions or 2-2-2 comps.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, a lot of their practice in the West was against 3 or 4 tank compositions. So when they came in, even on the old patch, they had to readjust to a Korean meta that was already in place before the big buffs and nerfs that we saw on the most recent patch, I should say.
That's a really good point. I mean, that's something we've heard from all the global teams here, is they keep saying over and over again, we can't believe how much the teams dive in this region, how aggressive these guys are. Something that you definitely have to adjust to when you come out here.
Absolutely. So we'll see if Prove and Carpe can maybe have a little bit of a better showing than they did against Meta Athena in that loss, and if Envy will not just scrape by on Escort and Hybrid maps, because they certainly didn't look great on the Assault or the Control.
Well, with game score being so important in this tournament, I think you absolutely want to win as hard as you can. Looks like we're going to be starting things off on Nepal. Should be good. BK Stars, you know, of course, did go down 0-3 to Meta Athena. They managed to fight Temple of Anubis to a tiebreaker, but aside from that, they were pretty outplayed, I would say.
Yeah, absolutely. I don't think BK Stars really has the firepower to do much in this tournament. Despite having a pretty solid last season, they seem to have languished while many other teams have improved dramatically.
You know, it seems that way, but at the same time, Korean teams on control maps seem to have worked pretty well so far, so maybe this is it. If they can win the control map, they've got a chance anyway. I think if Envious wins a control map, though, there's no way it's going to be K-Stars. But we're going to find out, guys. Time to go to Nepal, see who takes the early lead in the Best of 5. BK Stars versus Envious here on Apex Season 2. Let's get in the game. Welcome to Nepal. That snow just lasts forever, man. I mean, I haven't seen it snowing at all since Overwatch launched, really, but that snow will stay forever.
I think it's in the Himalayas, so I'm not sure the snow ever goes away, though. I think it's probably a pretty realistic interpretation.
Hey, I mean, sometimes even in the dead of winter when the sun shines on the snow in the morning, it melts a little bit. I've got a lot of experience in this type of thing. Don't question me.
I won't question you about your extensive experience in the Himalayas.
Oh, with snow. Snow exists in more places than it is in the Himalayas, Monte Cristo.
Really?
Yes. In fact, there was some in Seoul not too long ago.
Must have missed it.
It was the cold white stuff falling from the sky.
All right, so BK Stars, unsurprisingly, going for pretty heavy dive composition. Of course, Bernhard on the Zarya, and they're going with the Winston, too. So trying to protect that front line. Harry Hook going to be playing the McCree right now, and Taimu surprisingly on the Mei, so a bit of a switch up.
Interesting. All right, well, the Mei certainly can work. But Harry Hook, ooh, taken out by Bunny right away, and a couple of kills for Carpe. Not a great start for Envious. They're going to lose this first fight pretty hard. Ouch. Well, welcome to Korea.
Well, when we saw the first attack right there, Prove actually did land a very nice grenade inside the room. And they had that dive composition, got in the back line, got a big slash through, a dash through from the Genji.
Yeah. All right.
And Harry's going to switch over immediately to the Reaper to bust that Winston.
There we go. Speaking of Winston's, Taimu jumping in on his own Winston. Interesting swap there. They get the kill on the Bunny right away. That Tracer, not a problem. Now Carpe, oh, really good target firing by Envy. He's taking out the two DPS, and we'll see if they can channel that into a point retake here. Harry Hook very low, but he gets over the health pack in time. Envy is trying to retake the point. It's close. Carpe's back alive, so's Bunny. Envious has not taken the point yet.
They're going to get it eventually, though. They're still just working through this Winston right now. Eventually, they're going to be able to... Well, Pulse Bomb actually going to take out Internet Hulk, so big ultimate coming through.
Well, Carpe's back, too. He manages to take down Taimu, and he's got that ult in case he needs to use it. I don't think Envious is getting this point. Oh, maybe they are.
Yeah, taking out the last person who is respawning.
Guess so.
And interestingly, what we see is Coco on the D.Va and Mickey on the Zarya. So highly mobile composition, but they really have changed up a lot of their hero pool since the last time we saw them. Running without the Reinhardt for Envy is something that's extremely rare. It has been so uncommon to see Coco on anything but Reinhardt.
Yeah, well, Carpe pulls out the Dragonblade, has an Nana Boost from Cyan on the run. And Chipsyan's still barely alive, but oh, one more right click will do it. Carpe looking for another target now. Meanwhile, Alarm and Bunny finding some kills as well. Coco goes down, and BK Star is going to hold the point. Pretty strong, or start retaking it anyway. Don't worry, if I say something wrong now, I can just say that it is an alternative fact.
That's right.
It's still a fact. It's a fact. It's true. It's just an alternative truth.
It's an alternative truth.
Yes, that's
great
right.
Stuff.
It's, you know, it's nice to have flexibility, so flexibility in truth now.
Love it.
It's all the rage. Well, here's Burner throwing in the Graviton Surge, and there's that big bang that we've seen so much of. Envious got the sound barrier off in time, but a lot of fights coming. There's the Graviton Surge from Envious coming in. Coco out of the suit, doing the damage he can. Manages to take down Bunny with the self-destruct. Back on the point now, Envious trying to retake. They've nearly got that control meter built up, but man, it is somehow very hard to kill Twinkle right now. He is still alive. They're finally going down. Envious does slip the point back over, though.
Yeah, much better execution there from Envious, especially in regards to the sound barrier. Internet Hulk getting it down while the Pulse Bomb was ticking, so not able to take that much damage from it. And yeah. BK Stars, Mickey saved his Graviton until the back end of their own sound barrier, so the damage actually coming through from the side of Envious, and that means they'll get a recap. Dragonblade going to be coming in, though.
Yeah, Dragonblade popped out immediately. Chipsyan going down almost instantly. Carpe biding his time, waiting for another target to present itself, trying to do some damage. Big Biotic Grenade onto Envious. A lot of problems for Coco. The point does get flipped over to BK Stars in the meantime. And Envious losing people gradually. That's going to be the reset, but already about 90 control percent built up by BK Stars.
Yeah, Mickey nearly has another Graviton Surge.
Taimu.
Already, though. And Taimu gets taken out. Very clutch.
Oh, that was a bomb. Oh, man, I thought maybe stick chips, but he didn't quite get it. But that is going to be Village going over to BK Stars. Good start for them. But, hey, I mean, it's control. We've seen Korean teams do this before.
Absolutely. And Taimu right there was sort of the last hope to get back onto the point, given the respawns. Couldn't quite do it, so excellent push forward by BK Stars. But, I mean, we got to see more from Envious here. They switched that composition pretty quickly, but the Reaper not able to do very much work on the whole. I like them switching over to the Winston just because it gives them some more opportunities to easily take out a Tracer and a Genji. They're going to change things once again. And now Taimu on his McCree and Mickey on the Roadhog. Wow, big changes. Huh.
Yeah, we'll see if it sticks. I mean, only a couple seconds left waiting for it. But Mickey, we have not seen play the Roadhog before, and he will swap it back over to Zarya. All right.
I got excited there for a second. That would have been his first time playing a hero that is not Zarya or D.Va.
But going McCree and Reaper this time.
Carpe going to be matching on the McCree as well. So no more Genji. You're on Shrine.
Oh, there
Bunny.
We go.
And Taimu's predictive skills. He's very good at figuring out where the next player is going to be. Now they're going to get trapped here on the side. Fire Strike going through, and they'll have to retreat back inside the buildings on the far side of the point.
Yeah, it just seems like Taimu never misses those headshots, too, once he lands a flashbang. If you get hit by that, you might as well be hit by one of his Roadhog hooks. You are dead.
Yeah, absolutely. So Reinhardt shield spam going now as we see BK Stars recollecting. Looks like they're just going to try a just full-on assault here up the staircase.
Yeah, they're just going for it, man. Taimu really low, taken out immediately. Proof finishing that one off. Carpe coming around the side. Has to dodge out of the way. Oh, but he's taken out by Chips. Now Bunny kind of on his own is Envious. gets the upper hand in this fight initially.
That was cute.
Very low.
He did get a flashbang over the wall, Carpe, onto Taimu right there to stun him and make sure they could get that kill. Unfortunately, the reaction from Envy, very good, collapsing on that flank, realizing that McCree was all by himself.
Yeah.
So they trade McCree for McCree. Chips and Prove both with the nano boost up right now, so equal in terms of ultimates, but Coco with the faster Earth Shatter, and that's going to stall them out if they try and make an assault up these stairs again.
Oh, Arm's got his now too. Bunny with Pulse Bomb, Chips Ion goes for the nano boost. Coco does not have it. Who ended up getting it? Looks like it went to, well, Arm's got his anyway. Yeah, Mickey got it on the Zarya. Mickey, though, taking a nap in the meantime. Harry Hook getting a couple kills. Carpe coming around the side, though, looking for more, and Taimu fighting the McCree duel. Carpe rolls forward. Oh, can't get the flashbang over the Reinhardt shield, though, so that is going to be another one fight for Envious.
Yeah, making it look pretty easy here. Envy just holding this point forever, getting much more value out of their ultimates. Bernard still looking for a Graviton Surge. Mickey still has his up. This is looking very good for Envy to 100% this, just given their ult advantage. Bunny going to switch over to the Roadhog, but I doubt it's going to be enough.
Deadeye looking for some targets, but PKSR is going to hide themselves. Good way to buy time for Envious as they get closer and closer to finishing off Shrine here. Mickey does have the Graviton Surge. Wow, he just lobs it in there, man. Harry Hook coming in, waiting out that sound barrier. As soon as it's gone, there's the Death Blossom. Great combo for Envious. That's three or two for Harry Hook. Taimu picks one up as well. There goes Prove, and I think Envious, yep, no trouble at all on Shrine. So, rough time of it on Village, but they have tied up Nepal.
You can really see the difference between BK Stars and Envy's team fighting when it comes to using the sound barrier, right? The discipline much more present, even in the map that they lost from Envious, when it comes to waiting out that sound barrier so they can actually make more efficient use of their ultimates and get the bigger combos down, and we saw that again.
Yeah. Well, just big credit to Harry Hook, too, for being patient. You know, it's so hard when you see that Graviton Surge happen. You just want to get in there and Death Blossom right away or use whatever else you have, you know? But that sound barrier's on there. Best to wait a couple seconds.
And even though he got booped out, still got the kills that he needed to be successful. And you see Bunny on the Roadhog. And same thing with Taimu now. Harry Hook back on the Soldier. So this is the composition we may have expected to see from Envious coming into tonight. And they're going to try and use, of course, that Roadhog you can get on this far side of the point. And it's Reinhardt shield spam time.
That's right. Question of who can break it and get the Roadhog hook first. Taimu waiting for his opportunity. Oh, hooks, but it gets blocked by Alarm's shield. PKSR is backing away. Harry Hook's got a pretty nice flank on the side. Alarm, though, with the first one, get a fire strike kill onto Mickey, I guess.
Yeah, shield went down faster.
Yeah.
More Envious right there, and they tried to move forward and get into that alcove on that point to try and take coverage, but fortunately the cover collapsing and the fire strike moving through and picking up that kill.
Oh, there's a hook. Alarm very, very low in the back line, so I think he got booped into the pit. Yeah, Internet Hall claims a kill for the Bloodthirsty supports everywhere. In the meantime, though, BK Stars claims a point. Taimu in a little bit of trouble, can't heal with that biotic grenade on him. Envious trying to flip things back. Ooh, looking for that hook. Oh, he gets it! Goodbye, Carpe. Nice hook from Taimu.
Something hilarious about seizing Carpe with a hook. But
I know. Seize the Carpe. I believe that's how the old saying goes.
Carpe, Carpe.
Carpe, Carpe. Yep. That's perfect. I feel like I just want a shirt with one of those Taimu faces on it that just says Carpe, Carpe. That'd be great.
Taimu has such a meme face.
He certainly does. Alarm gets a nano boost, but also gets a lot of damage thrown his way. He's going to go down. Harry Hook. Cast Attack Visor got the nano boost as well. Whole Hog comes out from Taimu and Envious, not wanting to give BKSRs any chance at all to try to retake this thing. Hello, Carpe Carpe.
Carpe Carpe once again. Ever since that initial fight went in favor of BK Stars, Envy just having the better execution. Even that boop we saw earlier was a hook into Sleep Dart into Internet Hulk setting up the boop off the side on a sleeping Reinhardt. Just really good coordination to ensure that they get the clean kill.
Feels good, man. Alarm coming in. He's got that Earth Shatter. Once again, the shield wars continue. It's taking some damage, though. Envious is doing a good job of keeping Chips and Harry Hook on the side for the flank. They're going to go ahead and send people in with the sound barrier, but that's going to get countered by the Graviton Surge immediately.
Oh.
Coco with his own Earth Shatter now. Burner on the point, but with little to no support left. Does get the kill onto Taimu, though. Envious overall coming out ahead in this fight. BK Stars Oh no, they're fighting for it. Burner, they can't quite kill him because they don't want to advance off the point, but...
Well, they're going to have the faster respawn, though, which is why they're waiting right now. They got the later kill, so, well, Prove's still going to be running back right now. They're going to have to try and take this 5v6.
Man, and Harry Hook has just been untouched on the side here as well. No one's really been able to handle him. Now the Tac Fizer coming around the side. He's got to be kind of careful. Roadhog coming for him right now, getting to shoot between the pillars, though. Carpe, though, with the Deadeye, causing a little bit of zoning. No kills from it, though, despite the Graviton Surge. PK Stars. Ooh, Carpe grabs the kill onto Harry Hook. Goodbye, Internet Hulk. It was a nice try. Whoa! Flashbang headshot when he's on the wall. No escape for Lucio that time. And BK Stars might be able to flip this at the last moment here. Coco finally does go down. Mickey along with him. And that's going to be a flip. So 99% up to about 14 control percent for BK Stars so far.
Yeah, BK had to invest more than they wanted to in that push, though, because the Bernard's Graviton Surge just sucked people in behind one of the columns. There wasn't a clean line of sight for the Deadeye. Otherwise, we might have seen a really massive combo. Yeah. We're going to be coming in with a whole hog right now. Combined with the Nano Boost, this could be a pretty quick recap here for Envy.
We'll see. All right, going here in now, Graviton Surge for Mickey as well. Throws it in, they get it. Where's old Hog? Earthshatter thrown in as well, and that is about as one-sided a teamfight as I think you can see. Point being retaken already. Can BK Star stall this one out? Bunny is the only one left. He's going to get taken out of the pit in a hurry, and that should be it. Envious will take Nepal, the first global team to take a control map.
In this season.
In this season. I said that when we were talking to them in the booth, and Coco turns around and he goes, "We beat Africa Blue 4-0 in the finals." I'm like, yes, I know. I meant this season, Coco, this season. I should clarify, I guess.
Well, congratulations for them. Looking much more comfortable in the latter 2 points. It was a bit interesting to see their initial composition right there and the fact that they were putting Coco on the D.Va. Maybe they need a little bit more practice on some of those heroes, because after they were back to some of their comfort compositions, looked really good. And
yeah,
at the end of that fight, man, it is so hard to actually deal with a nano boosted whole hog when 4 of your members are caught in a Zarya ultimate. I mean, basically, well, that's a free point flip right there.
You're not going anywhere.
Yeah, you're not going anywhere. You're just going to take huge amounts of damage.
Yeah.
So really hard when we were already that close to an overtime victory for Envy to make anything out of that situation and try and recap after that.
Yep. Well, not a terrible start for BK Stars. They did manage to win 1 point on Nepal anyway, and that's the thing. I feel like we're seeing something very similar to what we saw in their first match, where you see these little flashes of brilliance from these guys. They have that individual playmaking, but just as a team, they're just finding it hard to match up roll to roll against their opponents.
Oh, yeah. Even just in terms of the communication and coordination, too, they're struggling to execute combos as well, or as cleanly as we're seeing.
Well, if it's anything other than the Big Bang combo, the Graviton Surge.
I mean, even that, they're not playing well against the Sound Barrier, right? So, yeah, they're doing it, but they're not doing it at the right time.
Well, see if they can change things up at all in King's Row.
Interesting that they'd pick this. I mean, we have seen some Hanzo play from Taimu on this map on attack.
That's certainly a map Envious you think would be comfortable on. We'll see if they can use that comfort to grab the 2-0 in this series, or if BK Stars will tie things up. Let's go to King's Row and find out. Yes, we got it.
We got it, Doa.
Twitch chat rejoices. It has been gotten. Welcome to King's Row, where there's a hotel. I don't know if I like that neon sign. It kind of takes away from the sort of classic aesthetic of the building, doesn't it?
The design of the sign and the font and everything really adds to it. It's not really neon, is it?
Well,
it's more like a hologram sign. I think it looks cool.
Sure.
All right.
Would you have a sign on your house that said Monte Cristo's house?
Of course. The Monte Cristo Hotel.
I think you would.
I'm going to open my own hotel, Doa, someday.
Kind of like the Bates Motel?
Exactly.
Oh, okay. Just checking. Now I know I will never go to that hotel.
All right, well, Envy, we'll see what they actually settle on right here. BK Stars going for a Genji on the defense to control the high ground. That's not very typical.
Well, it's pretty typical in Korea, I feel like. I mean, we see a lot of defensive Genjis here.
I'm not so much of a fan on this particular point, considering the value that you get out of a defensive soldier on the high ground here. Yeah. But
I agree. I don't know if it's quite as effective, but it is what we see quite a bit of.
All right, Envy should just be grouping up as a mob right here and trying to win the Reinhardt shield battle, because they've got a Reaper and a Roadhog here, so they should be able to just shatter that shield very quickly.
Oh, they're going for it. Mario dodging out, alarm very low already. Burner does get the kill into Coco to start things off, though, so BK Stars, not a bad start. Yep, Herpe gets a couple, and that's going to be the end of that. Ooh, hook into counter hook, and Taimu goes down to Bunny.
I really think that that was a mistake from Envy. They tried to rush before they actually won the shield battle. Here. But with their composition, they should have been able to easily break that shield first and not just get sucked into that fight. Yeah. I saw Harry Hook trying to get around the side of Alarm's shield right there.
Carpe reflected the sleep dart in a chip there at the end of that last duel. That's a painful one. All right, here comes Envious again. They've got a little bit more ult charge, but Carpe already very close to his Dragon Blade.
You guys be really careful about enemy Roadhog right now. And here they come. They're going to try and get through the hotel once again. So same.
Oh, wow. What is Zarya's shield? Yeah, keeping alarm safe there.
Yeah, same formation on the attack. So they get behind and create a pick.
Here you go, coming from behind. Behind, rather. Untouched. So far, Carpe comes in with the nano boost and the ultimate. Chipsayan in a little bit of trouble. Coco goes down. There goes Chips. Good start for BK Stars again. And Envious back to the drawing board they go.
Absolutely. They haven't even gotten a single ultimate fully charged yet. Chipsayan getting close. Wow. Their attacks have been a pretty massive failure. Once they get into the hotel, they're having trouble dealing with the Genji just dashing through multiple members.
Yep. Well, this is a tricky point to approach. I mean, there's only really one way to go. You have to go through that gate. I mean, yeah, you can go up through the small second floor in the hotel. Maybe they should try that. Burner throws in the Graviton Surge. Sound Barrier comes in immediately, but the kills come in afterwards for BK Stars, and that is about that.
Yeah, but the thing is that they, when we look at Envy right now, they did actually manage to take out Alarm right there. So it's an opportunity while he's going to be running back for them to make a very quick attack.
Perhaps.
And see if they can get something done. They've also blown a couple of ults of BK Stars, so Envy has a lot of time, and they could just charge here for six ults and try and make a decisive push right at the end of the timer.
Oh, Nana boosts onto Harry Hook, gets the kill immediately onto Bunny, dances in, gets hit with the sleep dart though, and then the Earth Shatter as they try to turn this one around. Meanwhile, Coco does get the kill into Proof. Nice pin there. Carpe finally taken out, and it looks like Envious may be able to get some headway going on this point. Let's see, Alarm. Yeah. He's gone, so Envious finally will get the payload moving.
Yeah, the death of the Reinhardt, the death of Alarm made it so that they couldn't actually set up once again too far forward. And Envious was very decisive about that. They realized even though they lost the last fight 1-6, it was still easy for them to rush the point. They had some nice ultimates. Just getting that nano boost onto the Reaper and having him carve a swath through the BK Stars defense. So,
yeah.
And so you got to make sure that you make the most out of these small timing windows, and Envy doing just that.
That's right. Internet Hulk has managed to save his sound barrier. Didn't use that earlier.
He's been a bit slow on this Graviton charge so far, but so is the rest of his team when it comes to ult charges in general. Alarm is low, gonna get that Biotic grenade.
Well, when you lose a lot of fights like that, it is tough to build that ultimate meter as quickly as your opponents. Mickey going in the back lines. There's a Graviton surge. BK Stars, actually that one maybe got reflected.
That was
reflected. I think it did. Yeah, Carpe reflects it. It's a nano boost right afterwards, and that is a clean return kill. Mickey's like, whoopsie.
Yes, that was definitely a reflected, Graviton Surge right there.
Mickey's been very risky with his Graviton Surges this match. He's been lobbing a lot of them from long range. He hasn't been aiming at the ground when he goes in to prevent that kind of thing from happening.
That was pretty sloppy.
He walked in and just fired it straight horizontally. So Carpe was like, all right, well, gee, I wonder why Zarya's running in the middle of my team. Now the Graviton Surge comes in from Burner. And where's the follow-up? Harry Hook will get hit with that sleep dart. Earthshatter coming in, though. Alarm gets a kill onto Taimu. And Harry's still alive for the moment. I don't know if they can turn this one around, though. BK Stars dropped the sound barrier just to make sure they win this fight. And Envious having a really hard time pushing this payload.
Wow, actually, a little bit of an overextension right there from Bernard, but several members will be cleaned up by Carpe and Alarm. I think he's still trying to get some damage down here, get some more ult charge while he can. Mickey has not been, I think, on point in terms of his Zarya's shields as well as projected barriers. There have been a lot of times, like in this last fight, where Harry Hook goes in and he really needs a projected barrier to make the most out of it, because he keeps getting sleep darted when he should be dealing damage. So communication seems to be a little off tonight for Envy on some of these engagements.
Yeah. All right, Harry Hook's been patient. He's got the Death Blossom ready to go. Carpe very low. Has a Biotic Grenade on him as well. Now finally getting some heals as Envious tries to push their way in.
Didn't get any value out of the Dragon Blade though. Mickey now, we'll see if he can do better at the next Graviton Surge that he has.
Well, he's avoiding that Nano Boosted Reinhardt right now. Oh, and he can't avoid death. Twinkle getting the killing blow there. BK Stars still holding strong. Only 1 minute remaining for Envious here, but they should have some nice ults for the next fight.
I mean, BK Stars is going to be running on empty. They used everything on that last fight when it came to dumping ultimates. Yeah. Meanwhile, Envy should be able, unless they massively mess this up, to push forward. They've got a Nano Boost coming up, and now the Sound Barrier there as well.
Okay, Mickey has just got to not let this one get reflected. Coming in, looking for the play. Harry Hook's got the Nano Boost Death Blossom used after the Graviton Surge goes up. Ooh, he gets hooked. Money with the hook there. Envy is still getting the kills anyway. The Sound Barrier keeping them pretty healthy as they push his payload forward. Looks like they should be able to get point B.
Harry Hook didn't actually need to Wraith Form right there because he had the Sound Barrier and the Nano Boost onto him. And could have just stood there and actually just killed the Roadhog instead. Wraith Form took it a little bit longer. Just these little things, it looks like the communication not necessarily on point. That time, BK Stars did wait out the barrier from Mickey in order to get the sleep dart down, so good patience.
I mean, when you play a lot of Reaper, there's certain situations where you just kind of reflexively hit it because you are familiar with the kind of damage that'll be coming in, but yeah. Technically needed that time. There's the Earth Shatter. It's a big one. Hit a lot of people. Coco ready to go. Internet Hulk with the kill on the burner. There goes Bunny. And Envious is going to get a lot of forward progress with the payload here.
Absolutely. And Burner crucially dying right there when he's the one with the Graviton Surge up. They need that crowd control to take this next fight. But Envy with no ultimates right now. Taimu not quite capable of getting up. But Carpe going to go down.
Yeah, that's a crucial kill here. Can they get any capitalization over the Graviton Surge? Doesn't look that way. Taimu does get the kill into Burner, though, in return. Envy is fighting. There's the Sound Barrier now. Taimu pulls in a Nano Boosted Anna. That is a dangerous thing. Or Nano Boosted somebody, anyway. That was Burner on the Roadhog, actually. Nano Boost now over onto Mickey, who's going to drop his own Graviton Surge. Bunny waiting for that cooldown. There's Carpe with the Deadeye, but everyone's hiding behind the payload, and it's going to go all the way. Envious gets 3 points. I guess McCree just wanted to watch.
I guess so, Doa. Okay. I mean, he had already started channeling that Deadeye, but you've got to break that and get onto the payload as fast as you can when those kills start coming in.
Going to try something.
I mean, that was just not even difficult for them to hide on the opposite side of the payload and just ride out the duration of the Deadeye channel.
Otherwise, it's like, it's high. Oh, I guess the match is over. Whoops.
A little bit sloppy, especially on that third point there.
Yep.
By BK Stars.
Well, BK Stars had a pretty good start on defense. Carpe, you know, certainly doing well on that Genji, but, you know, once it fell apart pretty hard, and they never really got things back together defensively for the rest of the map.
Certainly didn't. We'll see if Internet Hulk's going to stay on the Lucio here. Always a question with Envy whether they're going to play Symmetra. They are one of the more heavy Symmetra teams in the world.
Yeah. Well, Internet Hulk loves that hero, man. He loves playing Symmetra. And she's certainly viable right now, but we'll see. I would imagine if they'd be using it, he would have already swapped to it. I don't think it's happening this time.
Unfortunately not. But they are going to be going back on that staple triple tank with Harry Hook. They do love playing Soldier on the high ground on King's Road Defense. Seen it many, many times from them.
Well, they're very, very solid team defensively on a lot of maps.
So it looks like they are going to try for a sneaky little hook right here to start off the map, and something a little bit unexpected. They are going to show Internet Hulk going up to the door and playing Lucio Sonar.
Yep.
To hear what's going on inside the point, see if they can figure out the team composition.
And Carpe, though, right now, still on that Sombra. Wondering if he's going to stick onto that. Looks like Prove might take a couple shots before he swaps back over to Anna.
Probably.
What's that pick on Internet Hulk? Or not Internet Hulk, on Harry Hulk.
So they're going to see this. Reinhardt is there charging immediately out. So decide they don't like what they see. And just head right back over to the point, so they're not going to get caught out. Carpe, as you say, will be sticking on the Sombra for now, a pick we've been seeing with increasing frequency.
Yep. Try to build that ultimate and then use the EMP in a fight early on to try to take that point quickly.
Well, EMP going to be very effective against NBS's composition, clearing a lot of those shields.
Yeah. He's already up to 50% ult charge, too. NBS taking the more aggressive stance here. There's a hook.
Wow, not getting the kill.
The burner. The shot was a little bit high to the right, so he didn't land all the parts of it.
Wow, that's actually huge. And
yeah, well, Bunny gets a kill on the Mickey, too, so Envy is shorthanded here.
Yeah, that could have been a one-for-one trade, and now Envy really has to be careful, especially since Carpe getting up above 90% now has that EMP. And they're going to go in. They should go now.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. It's a good fight for them right now. 6-5, Carpe drops the EMP. Coco goes down immediately. They're going to go and use the nano boost onto Alarm as well. Harry Hook has that tag visor, and he's actually going pretty unopposed in the back lines here, doing a ton of damage. Internet Hulk with a kill onto Bunny. Can they actually defend this? He gets hacked, jumps down immediately, has to deal with Carpe here. But Envious for the moment anyway, they may have actually defended this.
That was such a good spread defense from Envious.
Yeah.
So Mickey wasn't quite back yet, but you'll notice that Coco was the only one on the point, and they had Ana and Soldier on different parts of the high ground, creating a crossfire. So when the Reinhardt went in to try and deal with Coco, they were already on the backside, had the nano boost and the tac visor set up. So Envy shorthanded, able to defend. And we've seen this from Envy before. When there's a Sombra in the match, they have a very easy time splitting up efficiently to minimize the damage from EMP, and they know when it's coming.
Yep.
Carpe is going to switch off after that.
Yeah, makes sense. You're not going to go for that kind of thing two times in a row most of the time. Carpe and the McCree now. DK Star is taking the high road. We'll see if they can hop down and take a point this time. They didn't even get the first pick on the control meter last attack. Envious ready with three ults. Harry Hook chips very close to theirs. Mickey really close to his. Alarm dropping down. He's got the Earth Shatter ready to go. If the shield from Coco gets taken out, he's just going to walk in and start swinging. There's a Graviton Surge for Envious. Alarm's going to get the Nano Boost. Nano Boost on both Reinhardts right now. Bunny, though, he pops a whole hog. Envious pushed away. Bunny actually does go down. Taimu getting that first kill with his whole hog.
It's just the play around these ultimates and the sound barriers is so vastly superior for Envious. They're so much more patient, and they chain their ultimates together in a way that they can nullify the effect there. They wait out the enemy sound barrier, and then they attack. Basically, right there, we saw so many ultimates of DK Stars do absolutely nothing, thanks to a Graviton and the whole hog coming from Envy.
Now, though, BK Star's on the point. Envious has to fight back and take this one. Gonna have to watch out for the Graviton Surge. Alarm goes ahead and drops the Earthshatter. Carpe gets the kill on the Coco from behind here. Drops on, Carpe with the kill on the Harry Hook as well off of that flashbang. Looking for more chips, very, very low. BK Star's holding strong. There goes chips. And now Mickey, him and Internet Hulk, the last one standing, and that is it. Last ditch effort, but BK Star's pulls it off. And they'll get the payload moving.
And that's one of those very slow flanks around the map through upper halls from Carpe, gets the flanking Deadeye, and it's either scramble or be killed right there. Envy, we see Coco just caught between a rock and a hard place, was turning towards the enemy. Reinhardt, no way to block that and continue to contest the point. So nice attack from DK Stars, and they're gonna at least get into the street space.
Well, Carpe is certainly playing better today. We saw in the past Bunny trying to find a option here. He came back. There's a Graviton Surge. Okay, Bunny with no ult yet, but they're going to throw in the Alarm with the Nano Boost. Both Anna's picking up kills. Envy is trying to fight back. There goes Mickey. And this one may not go too well for Envy. Yeah, the payload's going to keep moving.
Yeah, Carpe just right there.
Yep.
Picking up all of the headshots and cleaning it up. You see Envy just buying as much time as they can, but they are split spawning themselves just a little bit. DK Stars going to have another sound barrier very soon to push through up into the foundry, and Envy, they've got a couple fights left in them, but before the next point is taken, that is, but it's not going to be the most efficient. Bunny, actually,
whoa,
that great kill. Great kill. That means maybe a free point B.
Could be, yeah. Envious is going to have to fight this one 5v6. Carpe comes in with the Deadeye chips in the wrong place at the wrong time, and Coco, somehow the shield got taken down. And they lost him as well. So BK Stars, yeah, they should be able to roll to point B. Your Internet Hulk desperately tries to prevent the payload from moving, but that's point B. taken by BK Stars.
That was a great attack by Bunny. Both Bunny and Carpe showing up big with ultimates to take the first 2 points on this map. And they've got a lot of time left in the foundry phase now. 2:40. They're just 43 seconds from Envy. So it's going to have to be a pretty significant hold here from Envy if they want to take this map.
Things were going so well, but it's really seemed to fall apart here after they lost point A. Mickey with the Graviton Surge, that's a bit of a safer one. Taimu trying to capitalize on that with a whole hog, and he will. Envy is winning an easy fight here. Still haven't found Bunny, though. Taimu waiting for it. There we go. Harry Hook gets him with the Tac Visor. Envious used a lot in that fight, though.
Yeah, they really didn't need to use that much. Taimu actually going to switch heroes, looks like. Jumping off the map right there. We'll see. He's going to make some different selection right now.
You think so. Yeah, there's Widowmaker. Okay, so going for the defensive Widow. Just wants to get those picks.
Wow.
Want to maybe take out some of the ult options that BK Stars have. If he can get Twinkle, if he can get Bunny, there's an opportunity there that they won't have to deal with some of those ults, but so far not so good for Taimu. They're going to drop the sound barrier right away. BK Stars, Groove trying to look for some options onto the Widowmakers. Envious comes in now. Burner gets dropped by the Earthshatter. Carpe with the Deadeye, though, looking for some kills. Taimu, oh, gets out of the way just in time. Harry Hook, Mickey, everyone on Envious picking up kills now. And Taimu's provided just enough of a distraction that it looks like Envious did win the fight. Is he going to swap again? Looks like he is.
Wow. So interesting what we're seeing right now. Looks like he's thinking about it, but thought better. He's going to see if he can get another couple of kills by changing his position and peeking through that doorway, but opening up so much space. And the problem for BK Stars is that Carpe is really the only player on a hero that could actually deal with the Widowmaker in any sense. So that's part of the reason behind the switch right now.
Right.
And BK Stars dumped a whole hell of a lot of ultimates into that fight for virtually no gain.
All right, there's a Graviton Surge. Wow, really lobbed in there by Burner, but it does catch a few members of Envious. Coco jumps in there with the shield up to try to prevent some damage. Mickey's got the nano boost.
Taimu is killing
picking up
everybody.
Kills,
oh my.
I wish we could have gotten that from his view. Hopefully we'll get a replay. Mickey coming back in again, trying to finish off Burner, who's pretty low, but yeah, smarter to just back off and he'll be happy with what you won. They did lose Harry Hook at the end, but man, I want to go back and see what Taimu got those kills.
I mean, as impressive as that was, Doa, from Taimu, the real hero here was actually that nano boost onto Mickey during the charge from Alarm's Reinhardt, because they dumped so many abilities into killing Mickey, and they just couldn't get the job done. So while they were focusing him, and he had damage reduction, that means that Taimu is just opening up with that Widow.
Now, Graviton Surge again. Harry Hook gets a kill into Bunny right away with the Tac Visor. Great flank coming from behind and ripping BK Stars apart. They're into overtime now. Envious looking to win King's Row right here, right now. Zarya's shield saves Twinkle for the moment. Carpe in trouble. There's the sound barrier. Burner does get the kill on the Mickey, so they're trying to use what they've got anyway. Twinkle so low, he gets the boop. Harry pushed away. There's the kill finally, and they're going to give the nano boost over to Coco to finish this one off. Envious taking King's Row, but man, it was close.
Very close indeed, and such a late swap there from Taimu, but a good read considering the situation. McCree, the only threat really to his Widowmaker. He plants himself on the high ground, wins those long-range duels, and there's nothing else that they can do bar switching off some of those heroes. And the thing is, Envy's intelligence right there, they knew that most of the ultimates were up. That's why they switched over to the Widowmaker, because if they knew that their enemies were going to want to use those ults rather than switch immediately.
Yeah.
And when they focus so heavily on that front line, as long as Taimu can hit the shots, he'll be able to clean up the fight because he will just be untouched.
That's the thing. If your team is down in ults, just, you know, headshot the people on the other side that have the ults before they use them.
Or even just let them use them, as we saw. As long as they can nano boost a target and make sure it doesn't die, all it's doing is buying time for Taimu just to pick off members of the enemy teams. So we'll take a look at Carpe's Genji here.
Well, Carpe had a pretty great game initially on defense.
As a reflect.
Yep, good reflect on the Graviton Surge there, of course. And pairing that right into the nano boost with the blade. So, BK Stars certainly showing some life in this best of five, but it is a 2-0 so far for Envious. So, going into the commercial break, we're looking at maybe another 3-0 here, and if BK Stars gets 0-3, that's going to be a pretty rough season for those guys.
Yeah, I love it, though. Envy, smart changes, and we'll see if they can keep it up.
It's working out. Don't go anywhere, guys. We'll be back right after this.
목표를 보충해.
Welcome back to Apex Season 2 with Doe and Monte Cristo. Envious up 2-0 over BK Stars right now. And I think BK Stars have to fix a lot of things if they want to win this series. It's, you know, they've had their moments, but overall Envious has been a substantially better team, I would say.
Yeah, I think Carpe's been doing pretty well on the Genji so far. But
yeah, certainly much better this week.
Yeah, their individual play has been okay, but I think when you look at the coordination and their ability to read enemy team compositions versus their own, it hasn't been at the same level. I mean, you really can't say enough good things about that swap to Widowmaker, right?
Yeah.
If you think about how that play on the final Foundry phase of King's Row developed on defense, it was they used the combo that they've been using throughout the series so far, which is the Graviton Surge into the Whole Hog. Of course,
right.
They get a team wipe from that. And then Taimu decides, well, we used all our ultimates. I'm just going to drop off the edge of the map on the Roadhog, switch to the Widowmaker, and we're going to surprise them, try a different strategy. And this is what we're going to be seeing more and more, I think, from advanced teams, is that when the better teams get at ult economy and tracking enemy ults, the more interesting swaps we're going to start seeing like that, where you try and counter ult economy with a different style of hero or team composition and really just get the drop on your opponent.
It's like we're going to Volskaya Industries next. If Envious wins this map, of course they will win the series. PK Star is fighting for their lives in this series, and you know, you could say in the tournament as well. They have to win this one today to have any hope of making it to the playoffs.
Yeah,
it's a slim hope either way.
Yeah, and Envy, you know, if they close this out today, which they are one map away from doing, they will guarantee themselves a slot in the playoffs. We'll just be wondering whether they will be first or second, and that will come down to the final match in this group between Meta Athena and Envy.
Yeah, with the way Meta Athena's been playing, too, that should be a pretty sick best of five.
Absolutely.
Looking forward to that one. Well, it is time to go to Volskaya Industries and see if this series ends right here, or if possibly BK Stars breathe some new life into their best of five. We'll eventually go to Volskaya Industries.
You look at it. Look how nice and cold it looks, like so many maps in Overwatch that aren't Oasis.
Well, it doesn't matter because they build robots there, so it's better than all the other ones. Time to go to Volskaya Industries. Welcome once again to Volskaya Industries. Yes, color exists in this world of snow and gloom, but only upon the minarets.
Onion domes?
Buildings are our onion domes?
That's right.
I don't think that's the real name.
Russian onion domes. Yeah, the people call them onion domes all the time.
But is that really what they're called? There's got to be
there's a Russian word for it.
Yeah.
I don't know what that Russian word is.
Oh, I don't know that one either. We'll have to find out from someone who knows. Harry Hook. Well, yeah, I suppose you can kill those railings too. No, don't watch Mickey's point of view, please.
Well, Mickey back on the D.Va for this one. Of course, that mobility, very valuable on Volskaya point A when you need to be able to respond quickly to any dives that occur from the enemy team.
And just going for a very classic triple tank with Harry Hook on the Soldier 76. The stereotypical Envious defense. Ah, we may see more Sombra action. She's certainly been gaining a lot more popularity in the Korean scene here. Well, really, in the global scene, I suppose. But interesting to see how she does on Volskaya.
They're going to run out immediately, and we'll see where the first health pack hack is going to occur. Of course, if you can get into the bunker on the right side of the point from this perspective and hack that mega health pack, you're going to be in really good shape. And it looks like it's going to be a low ground attack here.
Wow, he's just going to run in. They've got the Reinhardt shield for the hack. He's got the hack on the big health pack. It's a good start for Carpe. Dodging back out. Coming from the side. And that health pack could just be used as like another healer, essentially, for your team.
Yeah, problem is for them now is that they are going to lose the battle from the high ground because they just sort of sat down there. But Mickey going to be taken out.
They're getting some kills. It isn't over yet. They're certainly gaining some control. But Carpe coming up from the top, going to hack Harry Hook, try to take him out, coming down from the top anyway. Envious, though, looking like they're holding pretty strong on the point for now. Just not enough, not fast enough. EMP comes in. Wow, he's going to use it.
Wow,
but
he should not have used it.
That was a pretty big mistake, I think, from Carpe. No follow-up from his team, really. Maybe I spoke too soon. It's just an alternative fact. Don't worry about it.
Well, actually, coming in, looked like that wasn't going to work, but they got the pick immediately off of the back of that from a Roadhog hook. So
they were all coming around from behind, too, and they couldn't play. So BK Stars will take point A in the end. And the
looking forward to that mini-map, that's for sure.
Oh, yes. The Lucio Sombra comp works again.
All right, so are we going to see the switch now, though? And yeah, we'll be Soldier 76. Really interesting attack, though, from BK Stars to start that one off, prioritizing the health pack hack just so they had a home base to go back to. The problem that you see there is that when you're on the low ground for that extended period of time, you can often just get your Reinhardt shield broken significantly faster, and that leads to a dangerous all-in. So, bit of a risk, but Envy will collapse, but That's at BK Stars with their pretty significant investment is going to find themselves behind an ult, and that's going to make a quick point B take quite difficult.
Mickey popped out of the suit immediately. Bunny wasting no time finishing off that kill as BK Stars goes in. The respawns are fast, but they've got a pick at least to start it off with.
Yeah, Mickey did actually prove off the map right there, so
I suppose
it's going to be still pretty challenging for them to make a very good attack here, but at least they've taken the high ground now and can start to poke with some of this damage from above. Mickey back up and back in the mix.
Yep. Mickey detaches the hook. He gets behind the corner in time. Bunny looks for some more targets. Carpe coming back now on the McCree.
He's on the low ground for a while, but yeah, finally makes his way back up the staircase. And it looks like this is going to be poke wars, but you know, if you got to capture that point, you have to come down at some point.
Oh, they're doing it now. Werner goes in after Coco. Nearly has that Graviton Surge, waiting for that defensive matrix. There's the Earth Shatter. Oh, he gets hit, I think, with the Earth Shatter. Not sure if that was Sleep Dart or Earth Shatter. Either way, doesn't get the Graviton Surge off. Meanwhile, Harry Hook, Tac Visor, and the Nano Boost going to get some kills going for Envious. Good start for them. Wow, that was very, very close. Burner, I swear, was about to use that Graviton Surge as soon as he saw Mickey get knocked down, but didn't get a chance.
Yeah, it was a Sleep Dart, actually, it looks like, from Chip's high end right there, considering Coco's still charging up on that Earth Shatter. But a little bit difficult to tell from that angle. However, that was pretty interesting from Envy. They burned so much time off the clock because they spread out and they covered the entrances, which made it difficult for the respawns of BK Stars to really have an effect in that fight. So Bird are going to be coming back, however, with a Graviton Surge and four ults now up for BK Stars.
They're in pretty good shape as far as the ult economy goes. For it now, waiting for an opportunity. Oh, gets hooked by Taimu. Very dangerous moment there. He barely escapes. Goes ahead and drops a Graviton Surge anyway. Carpe, ooh, finds one. Gets internet haul.
Oh, the clutch!
Wow.
Very clutch Sleep Dart right there before he could actually get that kill. Carpe was nano boosted, so may not have been able to get the damage down anyway. Turns that one around. It may not be enough.
No, not quite. Bunny's on the run. He's not going to make it. Envious keeps defending, and that was a pretty important defensive fight. They survived the major ult fight. Now just about 3.5 minutes remaining.
Yeah, now that ult economy is going to swing back in Envy's favor. Have a nano boost to ride out any concentrated damage from BK Stars. So that was a pretty big hold there from Envy, and they could look forward to another quality couple of minutes on this point before BK Stars is going to have a particularly strong push, barring some sort of pick that we could see from Bunny, a Roadhog hook, and not just a lot of poke right now as BK Stars looks to charge those ult beaters.
Yeah. BK Stars coming around the high ground now. Same strategy as before. Carpe, very close to that Deadeye. Harry Hook, ooh, they managed to chase Burner away. Burner very low health here. Bunny does knock D.Va out of the, or Mickey rather, out of the D.Va suit.
Yeah, Mickey was trying to actually boost them off the high ground and pick up a kill, but they couldn't do it.
And Carpe looking for some kills with the Deadeye. Oh, he finds Harry Hook, actually. Wow, did not expect to get, him to get anyone with that. And Envy is kind of scattered right now. They're going to send in Taimu with the nano boost. They're going to need a lot out of it. There's the sound barrier used, though, for BK Stars. So they're going to survive this one for the moment. Taimu's still full health. Carpe untouched in the back of the fight. Sound barrier comes in for Envious. That's going to let Harry Hook come out and look a little bit safer here. Oh, did I say safe? Didn't get on the point anyway. And actually, BK Stars gets 2 points on Volskaya.
That's right. And they actually comboed their crowd control well enough to keep people from Envious off the point at the end. And because of Harry's early death, he wanted to use that TAC visor from the high ground, found an angle, but was immediately hit with a biotic grenade. Couldn't heal up and easily taken down. So a sloppy defense there from Envious. Couldn't make the most out of the ultimates that they had. Held on to the Whole Hog and the Nano Boost for quite a long time, and then couldn't get back on the point thanks to the Earth Shatter.
Yeah.
See what Envious is going to do. Taimu, at least, showing the Widowmaker right now. Widowmaker on Volskaya A has been utilized on multiple occasions by professional teams. There's so much room to grapple hook and hit those shots.
Yep. Oh, we even saw Zebesai from Misfits insisting on using that Widowmaker on point B on this map.
Yeah.
In their last match, too. So
there's too much high ground cover for people on point B, I think, for Widowmaker to necessarily be the best option. But
it's out
on point A, you really have very long sight lines and limited cover available, especially if you're going to be trying to contest the point on defense. So Harry Hook back on the Soldier. Carpe actually going to be going on the Soldier himself. So they will be running a similar composition to Envy, except with Bernar on the Zarya instead of going with the D.Va.
Yeah. Time move. Tense move.
Yeah, just having a conversation right now. I do think they're going to go with the Widowmaker. It's something special that BK Stars may not necessarily be the most practiced against.
Yeah, Mickey may be running this Winston here. Interesting.
Nope.
Okay, I was going to say, you can make an argument for providing a bit more disruption for the Widowmaker to take advantage of, but...
Now, most of the time we see Widowmaker, it's in conjunction with a dive composition, but they're going for a more shield-based, passive, long-range composition with the Zarya and the Soldier here, so... it's going to be a pretty slow push in here. Normally you see a very aggressive dive and nobody on the Widowmaker, so the Widowmaker has a lot of room to fire, but...
Shot on a Carpe. Nice pick there. Now Taimu's in a pretty good position to look for a little bit more. Caught Carpe just around the edge. That was a nice headshot on a Roadhog. Carpe back. He's on the Genji now. Taimu still looking for some more shots. It's a very narrow sideline, but manages to get the hit onto Bernar for the moment. Now Envious takes a high ground.
I mean, this is a crazy crossfire they're developing, though. I mean, look, they're on opposite sides of the point right now. There's nowhere for BK to go. Nice dodge on the hook. Mickey cleans up the kill onto Bunny. That's a reflect, but not going to hit.
Now Carpe comes on the side, though. Oh, it gets him! Short range. Carpe. Poor Carpe. I think his teammates have to talk him down after that one. Harry Hook coming around the side with the attack visor now. And Taimu just seems unstoppable. There goes Alarm. And
that was
another highlight reel in the making right here, ladies and gentlemen.
That was such an impressive close-range scope. And Taimu has been wonderful on this Widowmaker so far tonight.
Beautiful.
Wow. I mean... He sort of got baited by the Genji reflecting as the Genji came out around the corner, but aim was not quite in the right place to kill himself, and then right after that, manages to hit a one-shot. Very impressive.
Wow.
Gonna stick with it, though, as they slowly push onto this next point. They have a Nano Boost to use onto Coco if they need it.
He takes a Fire Strike. Needs to worry a little bit about his health here. As Envious comes in from the side, Internet Hulk up on the high ground, providing some covering fire. Harry Hook turns it around. And they're going to have to deal with Bunny in the back lines now. That's going to be annoying to deal with as well. First Shatter comes down. BK Stars finds the fight they were looking for. And that's going to be Envious having to reset.
Coco was turned right there. His shield was going the wrong way, so actually led to a pretty easy ultimate there from Alarm. Coco is trying to stop some of the damage, looks like, coming from Carpe on the high ground, and didn't know the Earth Shatter was up. Ooh, got the body shot, but not the headshot right there. Still manages, with the help of Harry Hook, to take him out in the end. Helix Rocket doing the work, and Taimu's sticking on this one. Up to... He's got his ult now, so...
I mean, he's doing okay. It's hard to argue with it at the moment. We did talk about it. It is hard to find those sight lines on point B. Graviton Surge comes down. Sound Barrier in response. Bunny does get the kill on the Harry Hook, though. Envious with no real response for their Graviton Surge. Taimu, has to escape here. And
it's time to change.
Swap it over, yep.
I think that was enough of that. Everybody going to pop off the map and reset right now. As Bunny wishes them well, I guess, on the Tracer.
Yep.
So Taimu on to the Roadhog.
Okay.
At last.
I mean, if you get those early picks, sure, the Widowmaker can be good, but if it becomes this long, protracted sort of siege, it's probably better to swap it.
Well, you just have to ask, too, like, what's the follow-up? So they wanted right there to use the Graviton Surge, which Mickey dropped, but they didn't have any follow-up damage. When the Reinhardt shield is up, the Widowmaker not going to be doing anything unless you can get a flank, which can be, of course, challenging when there's a Tracer chasing you around, trying to prevent you from getting into a good position. So.
Yep.
Harry Hook died very early on, so the Widow was the only damage left. Not really going to do you very many favors when it comes to taking the point, but here's Attack Visor.
Harry Hook trying to do his team's favors with that ultimate combo, getting onto the point right now. managed to avoid the Earth Shatter. Got Burner very, very low. A kill apiece for the team right now. Nikki does go down. Carpe actually finds a kill before Harry Hook finishes him off. Got that Biotic Field out to gain a little bit of health back now. BK Stars going to win this fight. Yep, there's the reset from Harry Hook.
Taiba going to switch again.
Man, this would be so bad if they lost Inner Hulk. That is a pretty nasty staggered respawn that Envious is going to have to deal with now.
Yeah, very nicely done. So, Money just pushing out. Of course, the Lucio very vulnerable. Harry Hook will switch himself. I was curious why they were going to go McCree Soldier in a more close confines point like Volskaya B, but instead they're going to use the McCree for the long range, and then Harry going on to the Reaper. No ult necessary to be effective, especially take a look at some of the tanks on the side of BK Stars.
Yeah, Coca with the Earth Shatter ready to go. And Dragon Blade coming in. Oops. Funny actually tries to go for the Pulse Bomb. Carpe kills Nikki, though. Envious having a bit of a hard time. Oh, that flashbang. Farm's got the nano boost, but no one to really use it on right now. Either way, BK Stars holding the point strong for the moment.
Yeah, Envy, I think, is happy to take the next fight. They saw the Pulse Bomb come out. They saw the nano boost come out as well. So go ahead and take that victory. Try and put yourself into a better position. You just swapped a couple of your heroes. You know your sound barrier is coming up soon.
Yeah.
Make those... Play the patient game here and try and win out with ults. It's very difficult on these assault points if you don't take a big, big team fight win to actually close the game. And more often than that, that comes on the back of having a stronger ult economy.
Yeah, pretty much. Harry Hook coming in the side now. Swapped over to that Reaper. And he's taking the high ground. Shield Wars once again.
Oh, no!
Oh, boy. Wow, Bunny. Makes out Internet Hulk, and this is disaster. More BK Stars, it looks like. Oh, Bunny getting more. It's fairly cool here.
Yeah, but they actually have to keep on pushing this down, and the respawns coming in for BK Stars, man, that looked so bad. But even though they got that big Earth Shatter as Coco charged in, this crowd control, there wasn't anybody to take advantage of it because they were all in the cover of the building. But Burner going to try and drop this right now. Bunny going to fall to Taimu.
Yep. They're not able to really do anything there. Bunny takes out Taimu. And Envious backs away. Only a minute 30 left now.
Yeah, the respawn timer is really making the big difference right there, and Envy didn't have enough to quite hold on to that point. Bunny now with the Pulse Bomb back up again. It's looking less and less like Envy will have a major team fight win that's going to be necessary for them to cap point B.
Wow.
Got one tick.
Yeah.
They're going to have insane value out of this Graviton.
This would be the first map that BK Stars has won all tournament.
Going to be sneaky here. He really needs the big, big Graviton Surge right here.
Yeah.
Take a look.
Waiting for it, waiting for everyone to turn their backs and look at that high ground. There it is. And where's the follow-up now? Harry Hook has a Death Blossom, but he's not there. Going to just go ahead and use it on the low ground, but not get anything done at all with that. Larm and Twinkle picking up kills. Bunny finding the kill on the Gyps High end there, finishes him off with the melee. And I think Envious is pretty much done for, man. They've got about 40 seconds left, but no ults to use here. Taimu switching to the Genji just to try to make something happen, but I think it's a little bit too late now.
Well, Harry Hook going to be on the Tracer, too. They know that their last chance is to be able to take control of that high ground, get a couple of picks, and then snowball a win from there. Maybe being able to get up the Pulse Bomber, the Dragon Blade, over the course of an extended fight.
They've got Coco's Earth Shatter, but that is it. Nikki on the Winston now, too.
Yeah, they need to take the fight very fast on the high ground because that's where BK Stars has been defending, and they don't have time any longer to take the long route around the back.
They got to do something. They got to get on the point right now. Coco walking in, trying to tempt everybody down. Taimu over the top. Oh, gets taken down by Carpe, though. Not a good start for Envious. There's the Earth Shatter. Gets blocked. Responsive Earth Shatter. There's a pin onto Burner. He gets something, but they're going to need a lot more than that. Alarm's still healthy. Internet Hulk in trouble. Oh, Taimu! Did he get taken? Yes, he did. Bunny got him with the Pulse Bomb, and that should be about that. Chip's just trying to keep everybody alive, but it is going to be really hard to deal with those respawns. Not even a first tick yet. He's going to get the nano boost in time, but Coco very low already. He's staying strong, though.
Holy moly, Taimu's back, and he's actually picking up kills now. Coco staying alive with the nano boost was absolutely huge.
One man sound barrier. For Twinkle, just trying to keep his team in it. They're going to jump back in now. Twinkle does go down. Harry Hook with the kill. Burner going to go and drop the Graviton Surge. He's got the Nano Boost as well. This could be a problem for Envious. Harry Hook, Coco goes down, and that is finally going to be the defense, I think. Yep. think he gets one, but that's it. Wow, heroic effort at the end there. The PK Stars, they're going to take Full Sky Industries.
Man, that was very close, thanks to Chips with the clutch heels onto the Reinhardt. Also, a great biotic grenade to keep his team alive, the members that were off the point. Yeah. So very, very close as Taimu manages to make it back in and get a dash kill onto the Genji. Yeah, just not enough. And you know, I do think on that particular point, the Widowmaker, it so very rarely works on Volskaya B that you can't get greedy. You just have to switch off of it immediately.
Yeah, but you know how it is. So you get those kills, yeah. You're like, oh, I'm a highlight reel. And then, like, I can just keep this going.
You know, I know. I think it's more of a mental thing than anything else. You're right.
You get the Widowmaker fever. And the only thing that can cure the Widowmaker fever is just dying embarrassingly a few times.
Is losing Volskaya.
Losing Volskaya. That'll cure it. Yep. For a short time. It'll be back. It'll be back. Yeah, it's a chronic condition for some people.
I don't know. And we saw those slow pushes go through from NV2, but you wonder if they had swapped to the Genji-Winston combo earlier, if they would have had a more decisive take on the high ground or been able to set up some of those dives, because high ground control was pretty much entirely in BK Star's favor on that last push. And
one does wonder.
Yeah, they did a good job handling it, to their credit. So they will take one map win. They are going to have to win out for the rest of the night if they would like to take this best of five, and Dorado will be Envy's selection.
Yep. Just a pure payload map. I feel like we haven't gotten this far in the best of fives in a little while.
Certainly didn't get there earlier this week, Doha. But nope. I'm excited. I haven't seen Dorado in quite some time. It's a map that I really enjoy, and it's one that Envy loves to play Symmetra on defense. So that's something we may look forward to.
Should be fun. Well, NV is still looking for that win here in the best of five. BK Stars, they've got some momentum going. We'll see if they can continue it here on Dorado. BK Stars continuing to fight for their lives. NV is fighting for that win. Let's get in the game and see who takes it. I get it too. I get that it is the moment of truth once again for BK Stars. They will find themselves on the defense on Dorado, starting things off. Envious on the attack, of course. And we will see what the comp is going to be for these guys.
BK Stars not going to be sticking with that, most likely.
Well, they're moving out, but yeah, I'd be pretty surprised.
That'd be really surprising if we saw this actually be the comp that they want to run on this map.
Single tank, triple healer.
Triple support.
Yeah, there we go. Bunny back on the Roadhog now. Okay. I was going to say, yeah. Why do they got to do that? Why do they have to mess with us, you know?
Yeah, Twinkle actually going to be changing back to the Lucio. Oh, or not.
Hey, Zenyatta's good, man. No, he's good.
This is just
good hero.
This is just caster trolling right now. Well, we almost said something very interesting, but it'll be back to triple tank and Carpe on the McCree. It's very interesting that this series has been so McCree heavy, given that on this patch, only these two teams have shown a strong preference for that hero. Harry Hook, it's like he will be running it as well, probably in anticipation of a possible Genji, but he's not going to find that.
Okay. Me out. They have to deal with that biotic grenade early on, as you often see these days.
Okay, so nothing too weird so far. Pretty standard defense here. See if he gets some damage out. Maybe a lucky pick. And that's actually going to be a very aggressive Lucio speed boost.
Well, that was nearly a hook.
Yep, they were looking, fishing for that hook as the BK Stars members tried to reset their defense inside the choke point.
Well, connected, but it just couldn't get pulled back around that corner. Yeah.
One of the big changes on this patch, for sure. Yep. And this is about as typical as it could be. Pushing through, you don't want to walk through those narrow chokes on either side of the truck, so come up here and try and play on the high ground instead.
That's right, Envious dropping down. Nice kill onto Alarm right away from Taimu. Finds that hook he was looking for. Now that payload's going to move. BK Stars had to back way up after losing their Reinhardt.
Yeah, so difficult to deal with that. Looked like Chips actually hit a sleep dart right there on the Reinhardt in order to set up the hook in the first place. Very nice combination. Chips hitting a lot of very good sleep darts so far tonight. As usual, we could say, alarm back now. And that will mean that the defense will resume here from BK.
Yep. And we're waiting for that hook cooldown. Ready to go. Trying to come around the side. They're going to use the Deadeye. Harry Hook, not able to find anyone with that, though.
Yeah, pushes them off the truck, though, and really just trying to get that as far, advance the payload as far as they can.
Yeah. All right, it's Nano Boost time. They're going to throw it onto Alarm. Going to go after the Nano Boost. That was used by BK, or by BK Stars, rather. Coco gets it. They keep changing colors.
Again.
Yeah, we saw the same Nano Boost come down from Chip Cyan. Mickey has been more often than not the recipient of those Nano Boosts. And
well, that's one way to take point A.
Harry Hook just going to clean up the rest of that fight. And we saw, of course, the Sleep Dart coming down again, but they knew they had the damage thanks to the Biotic Grenade reducing the healing onto Alarm. So focus him while he's on the ground, take him out, and keep on pushing that payload. High ground. That's an interesting flank, splitting up 3-3 and trying to take the back of the high ground. You don't normally see this on Dorado Attack. Oh, Harry Hook. That's beautiful.
Yep. That's exactly what they needed. Alarm taken out again.
You don't expect that at all, right?
I don't think
so, no. High ground on the defense. You come up onto the upper balcony of the church. You try and get that drop down. You don't expect the McCree to come around by jumping on the window ledges to get the clutch flashbang that sets up the hook.
Now the hop flashbang over the shield.
Beautiful.
Every Reinhardt sits there. It makes sense. Bernard coming down now with the Graviton Surge. Envious gets the Sound Barrier off in time. Sound Barrier for both teams. As the fight keeps going here. And Bundy gets the first kill on the Internet Hulk in this fight. Chip's getting a little bit low. That's a problem. And BK Stars going to be able to halt the momentum for Envious for a little while anyway.
Yeah, finally having a strong hold.
Yep.
Been looking for that one. But Envy, just off of that flashbang, got so much momentum on that payload. And they forced BK Stars to commit pretty hard. That said, BK Stars still going to be feeling all right about the tools they've got. Carpe nearly getting taken out right there. Mickey. And Taimu, though, with that combo we've seen over and over, the Graviton Hole Hog. They're going to drop it from above, looks like.
Yep. Time for the Graviton Hog.
Gravity Hog.
That's right.
Love it.
Because you can't really call it the whole surge, can you? That's like what I drank in the 90s all the time. I drank the whole surge. He needs to worry about money coming from behind, it looks like. Oh, and that pulse bomb from Bunny didn't do a whole lot. Watching out for the Deadeye now. Mickey back with his team. Not really finding an opportunity for that Graviton Surge. Not quite yet.
Yeah, Taimu actually taken out right there. Harry Hook tried to use the Tac Visor. Well, not even the Tac Visor yet. Just getting the Nano Boost.
Yeah.
But they didn't actually make much use of that combo. Mickey held on to that Graviton Surge until he died. And the Hole Hog went down very early. Taimu back on the Widowmaker again.
See, Taimu's like that guy in every solo queue game where he's like, all right, we're losing. I'm going to go Widowmaker. But Taimu can make it work.
Taimu actually
unlike
carries
all the Widowmakers
Envy.
In my game.
Yes, very true. There's a huge difference.
Yeah.
Taimu's the guy who thinks he can carry you up Widowmaker and actually can, which is, you know.
If you're not Taimu, don't try it. Try it.
So very rare.
It's not a common occurrence.
Setting up once again.
Yep. It will. Oh, so close. That shield came up just in time. Mickey walking forward now.
Going to burn the Graviton. It looks like they want to just shatter the shield first, and they're going to get it.
Lobbed it in there again. He got knocked down, though. Pin comes in. And Taimu really capitalizing on a lot of that damage that was done during the Graviton Surge.
Yeah, meanwhile, though, Pulse Bomb is going to miss. Couldn't quite get the kill. Now they have to drop the Lucio just to buy time. They're investing a sound barrier into this. They're not actually going to stop the cart here at this point.
Twinkle did this on Volskaya Point B as well to buy time for the respawns. But I guess he did it this time too. He bought just enough time. But will it work out? Graviton Surge. And wow, Taimu just firing unopposed here. Burner goes down. And yeah, I think that that sound barrier from Twinkle wasn't the best idea.
No, and because both he and the unapproved died coming into that point before the rest of the team could arrive, there's basically no chance that they were going to be able to defend there. And now they find themselves without a sound barrier, have a few other ultimates to work with, but Internet Hulk really going to have a pretty big advantage.
All right, this guy can play Widowmaker. It's okay. I won't. I'm not going to question it anymore.
Not raging about his Widowmaker.
No.
I'm so a little.
Oh, it hurts so bad.
I mean, knew where he was, obviously.
Or Carpe.
Carpe knew that Taimu knew where he was, so you got to expect that. But man, sometimes you don't expect that level of accuracy as BK Stars find themselves a couple heroes down.
Oh, yeah, bumped his head on the ledge there. Oh. Next with the Earth Shatter, but no one there for the follow-up quite yet.
That was a terrible Earth Shatter, honestly.
Yeah, there was no one there to really do anything with it. And Harry Hook on the run. Gets very, very low here. He's got the attack visor. Carpe out of the suit now. He's like, there, there's something. Oh my gosh, Taimu finds a kill on the Genji in midair. What is going on here?
His angles. He's just setting up these huge crossfires, and there's nothing they can do to protect their heroes
just
from it.
Hi,
Taimu,
insane.
Oh my.
Insane Widowmaker play.
I don't even know what to say about that, Doha. That's just incredibly impressive.
I know exactly what to say about it. Thanks a lot for ruining solo queue for me for the next month, Taimu. Thanks a lot. It's all your fault. I blame you.
His positioning is just excellent.
Yeah.
And he knows exactly how to set up around his teammates so that there's no defense from the opposition. And he's basically pressuring them either into eating headshots and dying or pushing them aggressively into the main death ball of his team that entire time.
And the thing is normally be like, okay, send the Tracer after that Widowmaker. Send the Genji after that Widowmaker. And they try it, and he just kills them. He just kills you, like, at point blank.
Yeah. Yeah, he knows.
Yeah, he does.
He knows he's done a good
thing.
Poor
Carpe. Come on, Carpe. Carpe diem.
Well, it's gonna be a tall order. Only a minute on the clock left over for Envy, though. So,
yeah, but finishing Dorado in a professional match—not something you see on the regular. Internet Hulk on that Symmetra—that's something you definitely see on the regular.
Yeah, I'm a bit surprised that we didn't see the Symmetra come out on King's Row, but we at least get to see it here, Doha. It's one of those picks that Envy really does play better than almost anybody else.
Oh, and Internet Hulk, he's going for the classic, man. And
he crouched.
So, oh, I love it. I mean, it's a good way to build a good amount to ult charge right at the beginning. Sometimes you get a cheesy kill.
I mean, I do disagree with putting six on the doorway. I think that's like,
well,
that's a little much. I do appreciate it more when Symmetra players will stagger that over the course of the map up until the actual choke point on the arch right there. But
I think it's okay. I mean, because the way he did it, they don't know that he's Symmetra. They can probably guess, but they shouldn't have
they
any
should know.
Firm thing. Now they know. There's a big shield walking through the door, and yeah, okay.
But he got barely any charge because a lot of that damage went into the Zarya projected barrier instead, so I don't know. I think it's just better to set them up one by one, generally speaking. That way they're sort of slowed as they approach the point. You get more value out of your turrets, but
nah, just bad luck. It happens.
I think that was actually pretty obvious read there from BK Stars. Anyway, Bunny going to be trying to recontrol this high ground with the Tracer.
And Mickey's in a bit of trouble here. It's kind of low. Bunny, here's the Symmetra. Yeah, there we go. Finds the turret. And Internet Hulk, only about 30% charge. So, yeah, I mean, he is in a bit of trouble as far as getting that ultimate up. You really want to do that as fast as you can.
50% now. Has had some clever turret locations to try and push that ult meter up.
There's
but
a lot
they've
of
lost control of their flank right now. They didn't really take the biggest advantage of the choke point.
There's a lot of places to hide it on this map. Hide the sentry turrets.
Just trying to stay alive right now.
Yep.
Get some more turrets down around some of these corners, and he's moving pretty slowly, but Bunny gonna get hooked, not actually going down though.
Yeah, in fact, he killed Coco.
Oh.
With the,
that was not
Coco with the pulse bomb. Right. Second hook's the charm, I guess.
Yeah, that was pretty sloppy by Envy, though. You hit the sleep dart right there. You're not going to instant burst the Tracer if you left-click on her with that Symmetra, so waking her back up and allowing her to rewind.
Internet Hulk put down the ult, and it immediately got destroyed, apparently, because his charge is back to 11%. That's a problem.
Yeah, well, looks like if he does have that charge down, it was either going to be a teleporter right now.
It was immediately destroyed.
You saw it in the kill feeder, right?
Well, I mean, he's recharging, and you don't start charging if it's still up. So
that's That is very awkward for the Symmetra.
I play Symmetra many times.
You do?
Oh, yes. And yeah, what happened there is he thought he had a safe place to put down probably the barrier, because I know he likes that one a little bit more right now, and I got a feeling, unfortunately, Bunny was probably right there to kill him. Something has happened to all of us Symmetra players at once. It's horrible, but it does happen. Already up to 50% again as the Graviton Surge comes out for Envious, trying to capitalize on that with the attack visor from Harry Hook. Everyone backing away, though. BK Stars has lost a lot of members already, and Envious holding strong.
You can see the spam coming from Burner on that high ground as they were trying to eliminate the threat from Harry Hook's attack visor, but damage had already been done, really, and they're pushing forward very aggressively onto the high ground once again. So BK Stars going to be coming in with 6 ults, though. They have been disciplined in saving them up until this point, and there's still no shield generator for Internet Hulk.
Yeah, he's a ways away now, crucially. Trying to build up as fast as he can. BK Stars coming in, they're going to use that sound barrier and just rush ahead. Graviton Surge, Burner did use it. Where's the capitalization? There it is, man. They got the Pulse Bomb off just in time. 2 kills with that. Envious on the back foot now. Bunny looking for the kill, gets hit with the Sleep Dart from Chip Zion. And Envious fighting back. Alarm's got the Nano Boost, but so does Mickey. It's usually who they end up giving it to. Coco does go down. The payload finally starting to move again. Envious held for a long time, just 30 seconds left for BK Stars. So Envious does finally give up point A, but they cost BK Stars a lot of time to do it.
Absolutely. And the question is Internet Hulk going to switch right now? Taimu already back on the Widowmaker. Of course, Hulk will be able to just pop down that shield generator, but yes, now is the time for Lucio. Not on this second point. There's too much movement on the streets phase. You're not going to get a lot of value out of it, so I like just sacrificing that if you can. But really, it was the crucial decision-making for BK Stars right there. You could see Burner and Bunny just hunting down the Symmetra. They knew that that ultimate was about to come back up again. That was the crucial pick that they had to make to open up that fight. They managed to make it work, and
the duel. Bunny gets a lot of damage on Taimu in trouble. Can he get the kill? Oh, he gets him! What a shot from Taimu!
Looked like he was going to lose that. But man, every time they attempt to flank onto Taimu, he is winning the battles. And that has been so huge for Envy.
You're not supposed to be able to do that.
Also, Bunny is a very good Tracer player. So.
He's a great Tracer player.
That is.
Tracer and Genji should kill Widowmaker.
Yeah, that is a demoralizing duel to lose right there. Bunny going to try and take it round 2, however.
Yeah, well. It's just like that cinema, man. It's just like the video. Tracer loses that one. There you go again. Yeah, you can't fight lore.
He got Internet Hulk.
Yeah, he killed Mandato while that was going on too. It didn't pop up in the kill scene. That didn't happen. Whoa.
I guess Taimu is just going to absolutely run rampant on Widowmaker tonight. What a pleasure to watch.
Oh boy. Wait for it. Wait for it. They have to come out behind the Reinhardt shield. You don't see the Tracer hiding behind the Reinhardt very often. I guess you have to do that against Taimu. Gonna back away now. BK Stars taking the long way around.
I've gotta try something else, because when they have attempted to attack the high ground with one person, they just get picked off by Taimu time and time again.
Yep. All right, well, apparently his ult is active.
And he knows where everybody is, because Taimu just ulted.
Yeah.
So he was trying to get in behind right there and see exactly where they all are. Is not going to get booped off the top, crucially. So.
Yeah, that was could have been bad if Mickey would have gotten knocked off. They could have isolated him and taken him down.
Still has to be very careful about the D.Va, though, when you think about this ult. But, I mean, at some point, BK Stars needs to actually commit right here.
Oh, Mickey's just so threatening. They know he's got the Graviton Surge up. I don't know what they're waiting for, though. Gotta make something happen here. They've got ults.
Yeah, trying for a really long flank around the side right now, but really nobody on the payload for BK Stars. They've got 3 seconds. They only have their Reinhardt and Lucio on the low ground.
Oh, Carpe got 2 there. Mickey lost that duel with Burner as well. Burner firing from on high. The payload still going to keep moving, and Envious kind of a bit of a scattered defense, and BK Stars just kind of walks up and wins Azaria one-on-one for the most part.
Well, BK, they were winning the Reinhardt shield battle on the high ground, and they were spread out in a giant arc across that entire point B area. So
yeah,
a very slow attack, but ends up actually cracking the defense in the end. But Harry Hook is here.
He's got to watch out, though.
Oh, no!
Gets booped by Carpe. Goodbye. Bunny has a nano boost, meanwhile. Looking for a pulse bomb option. Doesn't even need it, I guess. Envy is falling apart a little bit here at the end of point B.
Carpe played that this point super up. Well. I mean, the defensive matrix coming in and then actually getting the boop off, eliminating two ultimates from Envy is crucial. And now they're coming in with a big advantage on the final point.
Taimu, what are you doing, man? He was way out ahead of everyone else. And that's going to be an annoying split spawn to deal with.
See if he's going to switch it up or if he's going to stay on the Roadhog. Yeah, will be a McCree change for him here. And Harry Hook now onto the Reaper on this last point, which can end up pretty close quarter combat.
Just 1 minute. I mean, the crucial thing is BK Stars really didn't need to use many ults to get that point, so they've got them now for this one. Alco jumping down, looking for it, uses that Earth Shatter, didn't see who it hit because we're looking at Bunny. Clear the top after Chipsayan. Chipsayan very low, turns around. Oh, he gets taken down. But meanwhile, Envy is getting the kills in the teamfight, and Bunny kind of finds himself on his own.
Actually does manage to escape outside of the ziggurat. Yeah, they noticed Bunny wasn't there. Bunny taking the long way around, so Envy collapses onto the front line, 6v5. Earthshatter does manage to land, and Chips High and gets a good grenade in there. So easy fight, but BK Stars again, they're coming back with a lot of ults, but they didn't have a chance to use them on that last push.
All right. Envious, this is the last fight they're going to need to win here in this match.
Great charge.
That's right. Bunny looking for a bit more. Coco does take out Alarm early on, though. Sound barrier was used by Envious. It's gone now. Bunny waiting for it. There's the pulse bomb. Oh, but it's Harry Hook, the one that gets the kill. Bunny does go down, and there's the self-destruct. No kills for Carpe, and they take him out before he gets back in the mech, and that should about do it. Envious will win this one 3-1.
And BK, they never had a chance to use a lot of their ultimates on that those last three pushes because Envy was playing so aggressively. They didn't have really time to set up any kind of combos right there. And that's just Envy knowing that those ultimates are available to use and knowing that they have to play aggressively to try and disrupt the engages of their opponents. And they do it successfully. But BK Star is really lacking a lot of discipline and decisiveness in those final pushes, I should say.
Wow. I mean, more than anything, Taimu's Widowmaker.
Incredible.
Some of the best Widowmaker stuff I've ever seen in that match right there. That was some amazing, amazing stuff.
Yeah, very exciting. Love the way they played Widow with multiple different kinds of compositions.